All right, so we should get started. Physics 7A. Glad to see you all here at 7:30 in the morning. I'm sure you don't quite feel the same. All right, so I'm not even going to talk about physics yet. First, I'm going to talk about what you're supposed to be doing, what I think you should be doing this quarter. And I'm not going to say very much about it. It's mostly about how you learn things. And physics is not a lot different than a lot of other things. Learning to play a musical instrument, learning to play soccer. You do not learn those things by having somebody tell you how to do them, or even having somebody show you how to do them. I can stand up here and tell you all about physics and show you all about physics, and you'll walk out and you don't know physics yet. You might know a lot of words, you might be able to say some things and make people think you know physics, but it won't be real and deep understanding until you've done a lot of practicing. And practicing is best done under the eye of a coach or somebody who knows, you know, where we're aiming. And so that's what Discussion Lab is for. It is all of the practice. It's all of the practice that we're allowed to give you, although you need more, and so there's homework too. Something like an hour and a half of practice and lecture. So I'm going to call lecture practice, because I am going to ask you questions and we're going to have a discussion about things. But also, Discussion Lab is a deep discussions about ideas, and homework, I hope, is also part of your weekly practice. Practice doing what? Well, a lot of people have this feeling that physics is just writing down a bunch of equations and then calculating a number, and it isn't that. That's almost the end result. But the end result, using a bunch of equations to calculate something, comes after a whole lot of thinking about what it is that's going on, how we understand that thing that's going on, and how that understanding gets transferred to equations. And then we can use equations. But equations by themselves are only useful for computers. You aren't computers. We want you to understand things rather than just calculate things. And so we're going to aim at understanding in this class. All the work that you need to do before the calculation, and then a few simple calculations, not really hard ones. It's an introductory class. So we're not going to ask you to do the same problem. I'm not going to give you on exams the same physical situation you've already done and have you just repeat the answer. I'm going to give you something new. And you will think about that using the ideas that you have been working on in Discussion Lab. And you'll explain that new situation or calculate something in that new situation. So that's what this class is going to consist of. New things, new experiences, new things to think about that can be understood with a set of ideas, and then the same thing in, so that for practice, and then the same thing in exams. New things for you to think about and talk about and calculate. So don't learn the answers. Don't sit and memorize how to do some problem. Do a different problem. That's the way to practice. Do something different. Sure, if you can't figure out how to do the thing that's different, go back to the one that you've already worked through and try to figure out how things might apply to each other. But don't study by just going over the things that you've already done. On this online thing, we're also going to be putting practice. As I said, there'll be practice questions. There will also be some practice quizzes. On SmartSite, I'll put old quizzes that are also practice quizzes. So there should be plenty of new things for you to practice with, some with solutions and some with not, without. So sometimes we'll have a complete discussion of the solution. And sometimes we'll have a partial discussion of the solution. If you basically know what's going on, a partial discussion ought to work. You ought to be able to fill in the pieces. All right, Physics 7, in fact, all of science, really, is all about, anytime you talk about any situation, you have to be really careful to identify what set of things you are talking about. For instance, physical system equals bowling ball. What else? Well, we could start with that. That bowling ball interacts with things. The first thing to do is identify what you're talking about, and the next thing to do is to think about interactions. Does that bowling ball interact with anything else? There are other things in the world. Does it interact with its environment? Certainly you know it does. This wire here is attached to it. The wire is pulling up on it. Why does the wire need to pull up on it? It's interacting with the earth. The earth is pulling down on that bowling ball. Okay, I interacted with it too. Interactions have effects. That's what we're talking about mostly in physics, is interactions between things. The results of interactions, how to describe interactions. The sun interacts with a plant and it produces sugar. The end result. There's a physical system there. Bunch of molecules, bunch of atoms. They are attached one way. These atoms are attached one way. The sun interacts with it. The atoms end up attached some other way. You change the system around. That's just a change in a physical system. Once you've identified the physical system, and the important thing is that something interacted with it. It's not so exciting to watch something that's not interacting with anything. If this bowling ball was floating in space, way, way deep in space, not near anything, it would be fairly boring. It's only when it interacts with something that it's worth discussing. So in Physics 7a, what we're going to do is not talk about the interaction so much, but talk about the results of the interaction. Energy can be exchanged. In fact, we're going to talk about that over and over the whole quarter. If I interact with this bowling ball, I can transfer energy to it. And then it'll have more energy, and I'll have less. It could go the other way, but right now, I'm going to interact with it in a way that transfers energy to it. Have I transferred energy to it yet? Somebody's thinking, and somebody said heat. Have I transferred heat to this bowling ball? Yeah, it was sitting there at room temperature, and you know, I'm above room temperature. My hands are hotter than the bowling ball, so something hot at high temperature, my hand touched something cold at a low temperature, and heat was transferred from the high temperature to the low temperature bowling ball. So the energy in my hands went down because I transferred heat to the bowling ball. The energy in the bowling ball went up. Where is that energy in the bowling ball? What happens when I transfer heat to a bowling ball? I'll give you a hint. My hands, being hot, have atoms in there that are moving around really fast. What happens to the atoms in the bowling ball when I transfer heat to them? They start moving around faster. They're moving around already, but they start moving around faster. That's the result of that energy. We can see it. A lot of it is in an energy of motion. You'll see that it's not all there, but a lot of it is in, a lot of the energy that gets transferred is into just moving around faster. There are other ways of having things move around faster through an interaction. I did it before. I can interact with this bowling ball. Now it's moving faster than it was. So I can move the whole thing, or I can move the atoms faster, and I can do that either way. And those are different kinds of interactions. And so we actually give the energy transfers different names. And I'll get to that in a second, because I have a few questions for you about another kind of an interaction. This is not an energy interaction. This is an economic interaction. I'm going to give you a minute to talk about it and think about it after I ask you the question. So the question I have for you that I want you to talk about, however much talking you need to do, is about this kind of interaction. If someone gives me $20, What is the change in the amount of money I have? So when we're talking about interactions, we look at things that have changed. Change is symbolized by that delta sign. Delta something is a change in that thing. Change in the amount of money that I have, money sub B, is the final amount minus the initial amount that I had. And so that's the question I have for you. Here's some possible answers.